another video. Today we are going to be making a little cookie pie thing. So first thing that you're going to need, some cookie, just whatever cookie mix that you want, one stick of butter, one egg, and some more things once we're finished with making the cookie. Okay, so first we are going to melt this butter. It'll probably take 20 seconds, but I'm going to do 10 seconds at a time to make sure that, you know, it doesn't really like get too melted, because you want it just soft, not fully melted. So now up here, okay, let's put this in. Then we're gonna 20 seconds. Oh yeah, I'll just stop it at 10 since I accidentally did 20 seconds, so. Okay, 8, 7, actually, you know what, I'll just finish the 20 second timer. It doesn't really matter. 2, 1, just stop it. Perfect. Make your butter look something like this. Then you will want a bowl. Let me find it down here. Find a good bowl. Sure, we'll do this. So, I have my bowl. Now, you're gonna dump the butter into the bowl. And then, you're gonna get some egg in there. Okay, so, once you got the butter and egg in, let me just throw this away real fast. Okay, so now let me rinse my hands off. So now, once we got our butter and egg in, now we need this. Oh, this cookie box.
Need help?
No, I'm good, Regan.
Okay.
So to get this, on this and the one that I'm using of it has. Chocolate, it has three different types of chocolate, and it has in their chunks. Let me go get some scissors. Okay, so we have some scissors. Oh, now the oven is heated to, and you want to make sure the oven is heated to 375. And my oven just notified me. Get out of here, Carol.
Again. Well, I have to get stuff for my girl, right?
Yeah, she likes to pretend cook. It's her thing.
With some real food.
Yeah, she
like, including whipped cream, but this whipped cream is not very good. This brand,
it's good for butter, but for whipped cream.
Yeah.
So don't get that right. Okay, so once you get this open, we're just going to dump this all in. And then, so after you dump it in, you're definitely gonna need a spoon. How did I forget that? Okay, so, let me get our spoon, or a mixing spoon.
What about these ones up here?
No.
A whisk?
I think that
a whisk?
A whisk, sure. Actually,
you guys can use whatever spoon you like a whisk would be good, or one of these wooden spoons.
Yeah, so I'm just gonna use a wooden spoon. Then you really gotta get in there, because the butter, once when it's soft, it's a bit, you know, like a bit hard. Even though it says soft, but when it's soft, it's still pretty hard to stir. So I'd recommend chopping up the butter while I'm doing this. And Reagan, she's still doing her play cook. Okay, so now once our cookie batter is all mixed. Oh, this is the wrong thing.
Oh, sorry.
We need to get the
You need a pan.
Yeah, you need a pan. Then hold on, let me just get the right thing. so we're going to take this out. So you usually want like something like this, like I'm using for this recipe, because you don't want your cookies to get all greasy if you have an old pan. Okay, so sorry if this is a bit noisy. Okay, so there we go. We got all of our paper, our cooking paper, put on. So now, with all of this, see all of this, you're gonna, don't worry, wash my hands. You're gonna make, for the thing that we're doing today, it's kind of like a pie thing, what we're doing. We're gonna want it to be like, so you want it to be all piled up. Then, once you get it all piled up, you're gonna want to get it all like this. You're gonna flatten it out. And since it's so big, it will still rise. And our dessert, it looks so yummy. It looks so yummy. Already. It looks yummy.
And it's a new recipe that we've never tried before.
Yeah, we've never tried this recipe before. So
we found it in a cookbook.
Yes, we found it in a cook.
No, online.
No, we found it in a cookbook.
Oh, I thought it was online.
Okay, so now once it looks like about this thick, sorry about my sister.
I'll move this so you guys can maybe see it.
So, it look like this. So once it looks like that. Okay, so now it's pretty good. Oh, that's a bit of butter.
Want to scoop it out?
No. It won't affect it. Okay, let me just wash off my hands. So now that our oven is heated, you get some mittens. Do you know where the glove mittens are?
Yes.
Thanks.
They are in here.
Okay, so now do not try this at home without asking anybody. Okay.
Unless you are over 12.
Yes. Okay, so now
you have your punching mitten on.
Okay, so I forgot, someone reminded me that before I do it, I need to make it all even so it will cook correctly.
You
so
dip your hands in that flour.
Yes, we do that, Reagan. I'm the one running the show here. So once it gets all on top, then we're gonna make it even more flat. We want all of it to be like one height so it cooks properly. I forgot to do that. Okay, this is going to be a pretty good big cookie, but I'll tell you why after we cook it.
Because this isn't just for a cookie.
No, you'll see. And if you read the title of this video, you guys know what it is.
But if you didn't, then you don't.
Yeah, like my sister, she never reads the titles to any video. Any videos that you watch, she just thinks. Oh!
I just look at the pictures.
Yeah, she just looks at the pictures. We want it to get even more flat. Okay, so now that it's this flat.
That's big!
Yep, it is. So now that it's this flat, we are.
It doesn't look that big from the camera, but like. Super good. Yes. It's like huge.
Okay, so now we're gonna put it in the oven. Let me get my oven mitts. Huh? Oh, there they are. Okay, so now that I have my oven mitts on, first let's open the oven. So once it is open, I'd recommend putting it on the top shelf just so it can cook better. So, now that I got my oven mitt on, we're gonna slide it on in there. Okay, so once it's slid in, we're gonna
gently
close it, and I set it to. Maybe 10 minutes. Hey Google, set a 10 minute timer.
Okay, 10 minutes. Starting now.
Okay, so it's been 10 minutes, but I think I might cook it for like 4 more minutes since it's not always cooked. I will see you in like 10 seconds. So the cookie is now ready. Okay, so on the outside, it looks a bit burnt, but it's really not. It's just because it's so thin that it looks like that way. But I think that we should let it cool for, let's say, 5 minutes. Okay, see you in about 10 seconds. Okay, so everything is done. So, now once everything is done, you know what? So, now, we're gonna cut it. Start from the middle. So, we want it to look like pizza. This is definitely a good dessert if there's a lot of people at your house that just want like a little snack or something.
Like for a birthday party.
Yeah, or like something like that. That would be a good spot to use it. So once we get it cut up. Okay, so now we got it cut up. Now we're gonna set it on this plate. Okay, so once it's on this plate, this is what you'll need. Ice cream. Some marshmallows. Some whipped cream. And some chocolate syrup. And you can do, like nuts and like other things. All of this is optional, but so if you want like a nice treat for a big person, you could use that. Oh, thank you, Reagan. She got me
an ice cream scoop up.
You know what? Let's see if we have a different one. One that I can scoop a bit easier.
Yeah, the ones are
Yeah, they're a bit hard.
But I did it before.
Yeah, it's about that one works. This one works a bit better.
We'll borrow this for a second.
Yeah, she's doing her pretend cooking.
Kind of pretend.
Yes, pretend. No one would
be Grandma. Grandma says it's good.
Yeah, Grandma. Okay. Forget about that. Forget that I ever said anything. So, here we go. One. I didn't get a big enough scoop.
That's why I choose that one.
Whoa!
And it's probably good to let it fall out. So, guys,
okay, so once you get the ice cream on, I'll just set the scooper in the sink. Then, and remember, all of this is optional. You don't need to do this. You could just do the giant cookie.
Yeah.
But just an idea for you guys. I'm gonna put some whipped cream. Man, that's big. Then, man, this is decked out. Then we're gonna
put some marshmallows on. And then don't forget the chocolate French drizzle. I don't know if it's from French or California.
Then you know what?
See these? There's some for me. Boys.
Good.
At least I have my extra in the bag, but that was all.
So that is how you make a cookie sundae, as you can see right there.
Our homemade recipe will be in the link in the description.
Bye.